for granted is something I hope I never do. I use it every day, for school, charging my cell phone, and getting ready in the morning. It's an important part of my life, and without La Creek Electric Cooperative, these things would not be possible. I even use the power poles to guide me in my running routine. Now that's using power to the maximum. Thanks, La Creek Electric, you make my day even better.
Well, it finally happened, Zachary. Somebody burned down my she shed.
Nobody burned down your she shed, Cheryl.
Well, my she shed's on fire.
Your she shed was struck by lightning.
Zachary, is my she shed covered by State Farm?
Your she shed's covered, Cheryl.
You hear that, Victor? I'm getting a new she shear she shed.
She shear?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's wonderful news.
Go with the one that's here to help life go right. State Farm.
Seems around here every town is a sports town. And why not? Sports were important to us growing up, and we want the same for our kids. To get involved, to compete, because that's how kids learn to lead. And why Farmers Union Insurance supports these programs. They know sports aren't just about building skill and strength, but about building character. Farmers Union Insurance. They don't just protect our community, they invest in it.
Taking electricity for granted is something I hope I never do. I use it every day, for school, charging my cell phone, and getting ready in the morning. It's an important part of my life, and without La Creek Electric Cooperative, these things would not be possible. I even use the power poles to guide me in my running routine. Now that's using power to the maximum. Thanks, La Creek Electric, you make my day even better.
Well, it finally happened, Zachary. Somebody burned down my she shed.
Nobody burned down your she shed, Cheryl.
Well, my she shed's on fire.
Your she shed was struck by lightning.
Zachary, is my she shed covered by State Farm?
Your she shed's covered, Cheryl.
You hear that, Victor? I'm getting a new she shear she shed.
She shear?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's wonderful news.
Go with the one that's here to help life go right. State Farm.
Seems around here every town is a sports town. And why not? Sports were important to us growing up, and we want the same for our kids. To get involved, to compete, because that's how kids learn to lead. And why Farmers Union Insurance supports these programs. They know sports aren't just about building skill and strength, but about building character. Farmers Union Insurance. They don't just protect our community, they invest in it.
Taking electricity for granted is something I hope I never do. I use it every day, for school, charging my cell phone, and getting ready in the morning. It's an important part of my life, and without La Creek Electric Cooperative, these things would not be possible. I even use the power poles to guide me in my running routine. Now that's using power to the maximum. Thanks, La Creek Electric, you make my day even better.
We hope you are all enjoying the student productions of your school. Tonight's event and every event produced by your school during the school year are created, filmed, and produced by the students you love to follow and support. Become a booster of your school's live event coverage by becoming a sponsor. It's a great way to show your support of the athletes and students in your community. As a sponsor, you'll get great visibility for your business, organization, or family by supporting the live productions of your school.
Whether you're traveling to or from the game, make a stop at Discount Fuel in Kadoka. They have a large variety of foods from hot stuffed pizza, roasted chicken, sub sandwiches, and their famous chicken gizzards. They can accommodate large groups and orders. Call them at 605-837-2271. While filling your belly, refuel your tanks with gas or diesel. They look forward to serving your needs. Discount Fuel and Kadoka Oil are proud supporters of area student athletes and wish them the best of luck in all their activities.
Life's an adventure filled with excitement, challenges, and achievements. Farmers Union Insurance can provide you the safety net to keep you moving toward your goals and enjoying life's rewards. With multiple locations across the state, Farmers Union Insurance agents provide quick quotes and professional services you deserve. Since 1948, Farmers Union Insurance has focused on insuring the people of South Dakota. From the most remote quarter section to the busiest intersection, Farmers Union Insurance, insuring a brighter tomorrow.
Bennett County Hospital, Nursing Home, and Rural Health Clinic is your local health care provider. They offer a full-time ambulance service, physical therapy, home health care, occupational therapy, and outpatient psychiatry. Bennett County Health Care Services will provide your family with lifelong health care from infancy to the later years with top-notch nursing home care. They remind you to get your yearly checkup and don't forget those flu shots. Bennett County Health Care Providers are proud sponsors of all Bennett County students and wish them the best in all their school activities.
This is Barbara. Barbara likes doing adventurous things, like bungee jumping.
Ow!
Barbara likes to take chances, but not with her finances, which is why she banks at Security First Bank. Their straightforward checking, savings, and lending services mean she never has to take a leap of faith.
Woohoo!
Security First Bank, a relationship you can count on. Member FDIC.
Living in a remote rural area can be a challenge, but the electric cooperatives have not only kept up, but have moved forward with the advancement of technology. Having three young daughters, we can enjoy living in the country and still have all the comforts just like any other community. It really is quite remarkable. Dependable, reliable service. That's La Creek Electric Cooperative.
A message from La Creek Electric, your local Touchstone Cooperative.
Hey, Doug, how'd that discount double check work out for you?
Oh, that was great. Good. I wish I had double checked before discussing that play earlier.
Did anybody catch that play?
No.
Okay, we're going to act like we're debating about it. You two do the bouncy football thing. You rub your head like it's a real tough call. No, that looks like you're having a migraine. I'm going to break the huddle confidently, and we're going to call it incomplete.
Your mic's on! First down! Thank you!
70,000 people were there.
20 million more watching at home.
Got it!
Save big with State Farm.
We hope you are all enjoying the student productions of your school. Tonight's event and every event produced by your school during the school year are created, filmed, and produced by the students you love to follow and support. Become a booster of your school's live event coverage by becoming a sponsor. It's a great way to show your support of the athletes and students in your community. As a sponsor, you'll get great visibility for your business, organization, or family by supporting the live productions of your school.
Whether you're traveling to or from the game, make a stop at Discount Fuel in Kadoka. They have a large variety of foods from hot stuffed pizza, roasted chicken, sub sandwiches, and their famous chicken gizzards. They can accommodate large groups and orders. Call them at 605-837-2271. While filling your belly, refuel your tanks with gas or diesel. They look forward to serving your needs. Discount Fuel and Kadoka Oil are proud supporters of area student athletes and wish them the best of luck in all their activities.
Life's an adventure filled with excitement, challenges, and achievements. Farmers Union Insurance can provide you the safety net to keep you moving toward your goals and enjoying life's rewards. With multiple locations across the state, Farmers Union Insurance agents provide quick quotes and professional services you deserve. Since 1948, Farmers Union Insurance has focused on insuring the people of South Dakota. From the most remote quarter section to the busiest intersection, Farmers Union Insurance, insuring a brighter tomorrow.
Bennett County Hospital, Nursing Home, and Rural Health Clinic is your local health care provider. They offer a full-time ambulance service, physical therapy, home health care, occupational therapy, and outpatient psychiatry. Bennett County Health Care Services will provide your family with lifelong health care from infancy to the later years with top-notch nursing home care. They remind you to get your yearly checkup and don't forget those flu shots. Bennett County Health Care Providers are proud sponsors of all Bennett County students and wish them the best in all their school activities.
This is Barbara. Barbara likes doing adventurous things, like bungee jumping.
Ow!
Barbara likes to take chances, but not with her finances, which is why she banks at Security First Bank. Their straightforward checking, savings, and lending services mean she never has to take a leap of faith.
Woo-hoo!
Security First Bank, a relationship you can count on. Member FDIC.
Living in a remote rural area can be a challenge, but the electric cooperatives have not only kept up, but have moved forward with the advancement of technology. Having three young daughters, we can enjoy living in the country and still have all the comforts just like any other community. It really is quite remarkable. Dependable, reliable service. That's La Creek Electric Cooperative.
A message from La Creek Electric, your local Touchstone Cooperative.
Hey, Doug, how'd that discount double check work out for you?
Oh, that was great. Good. I wish I had double checked before discussing that play earlier.
Did anybody catch that play?
No.
Okay, we're going to act like we're debating about it. You two do the bouncy football thing. You rub your head like it's a real tough call. No, that looks like you're having a migraine. I'm going to break the huddle confidently, and we're going to call it incomplete.
Mic's on!
First down! Thank you!
70,000 people were there.
20 million more watching at home.
Got it!
Save big with State Farm.
We hope you are all enjoying the student productions of your school. Tonight's event and every event produced by your school during the school year are created, filmed, and produced by the students you love to follow and support. Become a booster of your school's live event coverage by becoming a sponsor. It's a great way to show your support of the athletes and students in your community. As a sponsor, you'll get great visibility for your business, organization, or family by supporting the live productions of your school.
Whether you're traveling to or from the game, make a stop at Discount Fuel in Kadoka. They have a large variety of foods from hot stuffed pizza, roasted chicken, sub sandwiches, and their famous chicken gizzards. They can accommodate large groups and orders. Call them at 605-837-2271. While filling your belly, refuel your tanks with gas or diesel. They look forward to serving your needs. Discount Fuel and Kadoka Oil are proud supporters of area student athletes and wish them the best of luck in all their activities.
Life's an adventure filled with excitement, challenges, and achievement. Farmers Union Insurance can provide you the safety net to keep you moving toward your goals and enjoying life's rewards. With multiple locations across the state, Farmers Union Insurance agents provide quick quotes and professional services you deserve. Since 1948, Farmers Union Insurance has focused on insuring the people of South Dakota. From the most remote quarter section to the busiest intersection, Farmers Union Insurance, insuring a brighter tomorrow.
Bennett County Hospital, Nursing Home, and Rural Health Clinic is your local health care provider. They offer a full-time ambulance service, physical therapy, home health care, occupational therapy, and outpatient psychiatry. Bennett County Health Care Services will provide your family with lifelong health care from infancy to the later years with top-notch nursing home care. They remind you to get your yearly checkup and don't forget those flu shots. Bennett County Health Care Providers are proud sponsors of all Bennett County students and wish them the best in all their school activities.
From the visiting Hayes Springs Hawks.
A senior forward, number 12, Jacoby Hendershot. A junior forward, number 22, Alex Lewandman. And a junior guard, number 24, Shucky Collier. The work that goes in that market, bringing assisted by Patricia Miller.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the second game of the evening. My name is Michael Barno, assisted, as always, by Hunter Connect. Jacoby Hendershot, Jacoby Hendershot will jump, and number one, Charles Twarling, will jump for Hay Springs. And there's a jump, and easily controlled by Hendershot, gets it out to the white man. Mo Curry now has it, dribbles up past half court. He dribbles over to his right, gets it to Chucky Cotier. Chucky throws inside to Alex. Alex back to Chucky. Chucky takes the three. It's off the back of the iron, no good. Rebounded by number two, Gabe Varvel. Throws it over to number 13, that's Logan DaCosta, but he can't handle it, and it goes out of bounds. So, Cotier throws it into Mo Curry. Curry brings it up the court. The Hawks employing a 2-3 scheme. Frank Huber takes a three from the corner. It's off of. It's way up off the backboard, and it's good. So Frank Huber gets it to go. And Charles Twarling brings up the court. Going between the legs. Dribbles to his right. Kicks it over the corner to Varvel. Varvel dribbles to the middle. Top of the key. Dribbles around. Dribbles over to his left. Picks up the dribble. Throws it back to Twarling. Twarling gets a screen from 25. That's Sherbarth. Toby Sherbarth. Back to Varvel. Varvel takes a three. It's off the glass. No good. Rebounded by number 21. That's Cade Moore. Number 13 takes the shot. It's off the rim. No good. Sherbarth with another one. That's swatted out of there by Hendershot. Alex, little white man, gets the steal. Hendershot blows by everybody, puts it up. It's no good. Rebounded by Moore. Moore gets it to Varvel, who dribbles up the court. Throws it up to the top of the key to Twarling. Twarling gets a screen, moves to his right. He now drives in, puts it up off the glass, and it's good. 3-2 the score. Chucky Cotier with the ball, crosses midcourt. Looks to pass, throws it across the court to Hendershot. Hendershot will take a wide open three. It's off. Rebounded by Curry. Curry throws it in the corner for Frank. Frank fakes the shot, throws it back to Curry, who has it at the top of the key. He dribbles off to his right. Kicks it. No, fakes the kick. Now puts it off the glass. It doesn't go. Rebounded by Alex, little white man. And he just slips. The ball is battled for. And we're going to have a jump. It's going to go over to the Hawks. So the Hay Springs Hawks get possession on the jump ball. Twarling has it. Walks it up the court. Throws it up to Varvel. Varvel dribbles around. They're looking to set up the offense. Gets it over to Twarling. Twarling gets the screen. He dribbles off to his right. Kicks to Varvel. Varvel will drive. Puts up the runner. And he gets it to go. 4-2 now the score. Curry has the ball. Dribbles up past midcourt. Throws it over to Hendershot. Hendershot throws it to Curry. Curry dribbles over to his left. He drives, kicks it to Mo. Mo now drives. Oh, but he walked first. So a turnover committed by the Warriors. And it looks like Coach Ron Olson is going to take a 30-second timeout. So we will take a short break, and we'll be right back after these messages.
We hope you are all enjoying the student productions of your school. Tonight's event and every event produced by your school during the school year are created, filmed, and produced by the students you love to follow and support. Become a booster of your school's live event coverage by becoming a sponsor. It's a great way to show your support of the athletes and students in your community. As a sponsor, you'll get great visibility for your business, organization, or family by supporting the live productions of your school.
All right, and we're back at the Legion. Twarling has the ball for Hay Springs. Gets a screen. He doesn't use it. Drives off to his right. Kicks to Varvel in the corner. Varvel will take the three. And he gets it to go. 7-3 now the score. Hay Springs leads in the game. Curry kicks over to, and that's Cotier. Can't get it to go. Alex Little White Man gets the board. It doesn't go again. Now Cotier gets the rebound. Puts it off the glass and it's good. Twarling takes the inbound. He dribbles up the court. Passes half court now. Throws it over to number 13. That is Logan DaCosta. Back to Varvel. Varvel drives to his right. Throws it over to Twarling. Twarling will drive the baseline and he will put it up. Whoa, he puts it up behind. I'm not sure I've ever seen that before. He tried to shoot it from behind the backboard. And he, in any event, he couldn't get the trick shot to go. And 7-5 is now the score. Curry has it for the Warriors. Crosses half court. Dribbles over to his left. Dribbles to the top of the key to Heathershaw. Heathershaw fakes a shot, fakes a pass. Throws it over to Huber. Huber gets it to Curry. Curry now dribbles in. Throws it down to the Alex Little White Man who drove the baseline. And he gets it to go. So 7-7 now to score. So Alex drives the baseline and gets the pass. He gets the shot to go. Twarling throws it to DaCosta. DaCosta gets a screen. He dribbles in. He tries to put it up and he's rejected. And a foul going to be called against Toby Sherbarth down low. So I just realized something. Ron Olson, the head coach for Hay Springs, coaches both the boys and the girls. So the guy's pulling double duty. Man, hats off to him. So here goes Lyle Cotier. Throws into Tate Standing Bear. Standing Bear puts it up and it's good. Twarling takes the inbound pass. Drives it up the court. The Warriors have gone on a 7-0 run to retake the lead. Twarling takes the three. It's off the front of the rim. No good. Chased down by Heathershaw, who brings it up the court. He throws it into the corner to Curry. Oh, and Curry walks again. Oh, it's the second traveling call committed by Curry in this first quarter. 3 minutes and 31 seconds to go. 9-7 is the score. Twarling looking to go. Throws up the court to Garrett, to Sherbarth. Toby Sherbarth throws it over to, that's Varvel. Throws it up. Varvel puts it up. It's no good, but he gets the putback from Cade Moore. So a tie ball game at 9. Cotier brings up the court. Calling for a knife. Here goes Lyle. Throws it in the corner to Standing Bear. Gets it back to Heathershaw. Throws it over to Cotier. Cotier throws it inside. It's turned over. And that's Moore now bringing it up the court. Cade Moore dribbles around on the outside. Whoa, and he almost gets it stolen away. Throws it in the corner of Varvel. Varvel takes the three, and he gets that to go. 12-9. 2 minutes and 35 seconds to go. Cotier throws it over to Curry. Curry into the corner to Heathershaw. He'll take the three, and he gets it to go. Heathershaw with a sweet touch on the corner. 12-12 now the score. We're going back and forth here. Twarling dribbles over to his right. He'll drive. He looks to get it going. Cade Moore gets the loose ball. Heathershaw comes up with it temporarily. Twarling now has it. Throws it out to Sherbarth. Sherbarth misses, and Cotier gets the rebound. Oh, Cotier throws it way up court to Lyle, who can't collect it, and it's thrown out of bounds. So a turnover committed by the Warriors. Mo Curry will leave the game temporarily. Sam Byrne has checked in to see his first action of the night. 2 minutes and 2 seconds to go. Twarling now has the ball, picks up the dribble, throws it over to Moore. Moore dribbles, throws over to Sherbarth. Sherbarth tries to go behind the back, and they're calling a foul. They're calling Tate Standing Bear for the foul, his first of the contest, team first against the Warriors. Sherbarth takes the inbound pass, gets it up top of the key to Twarling. Now Varvel's got it at three. He tries to dribble, and he almost loses it, throws it back to Twarling. who dribbles over to his right. They're trying to get a screen, can't get it. Twirling throws into the corner to Cade Moore, who fakes the shot, gets it back to Twirling. Twirling drives the baseline. He puts it up. It's no good. Now Cotier's got the rebound. They're looking to run. Throws it ahead to Sam Byrne. Can't collect it, and it goes out of bounds. So a minute 22 to go in this one. So Twirling takes the inbound, gives it back to Moore. Moore is now heading up the court. Gets a screen. Dribbles around. Throws it over to Varvel. Varvel dribbles. Lyle Cotier guards. Varvel will take the three. And it's off the mark. Strong rebound by Heathershaw. 1 minute to go in the first quarter. Chucky Cotier throws it to Lyle. Lyle will take the three. It's off the rim. No good. Rebounded. Oh, a foul. They're going to call a push against, I believe it is going to go against Toby Sherbarth. That is his second of the first quarter. And in comes number 45. That is James Sherbarth, who takes his place. So Toby's going to have a seat. Cotier throws it into Heathershaw. Long three. Oh, it rims in and out. Rebound. Rebound by James Sherbarth right off the bench. And there's Moore. Dribbles around. Loses the ball. Throws over to Twirling. Twirling takes a three. No good. Rebound collected by Standing Bear. Standing Bear throws it ahead to Sam Byrne. Byrne gets it poked out of bounds by Twirling. 33.4 seconds to go in the first quarter. Sam Byrne to inbound. Throws into Cotier. Throws it back to Byrne, who dribbles to the middle. Throws it to Heathershaw. Heathershaw goes inside to Standing Bear. Into the corner to Chucky. Chucky takes the three. It's off the mark. Byrne with the rebound. Heathershaw has it on the elbow. Now Heathershaw is going to be aggressive. Drive. We have a foul. And one. They're going to count the basket. And Heathershaw will go to the line for a shot at a three-point play. Foul will go on number 21, Cade Moore. That is his first of the contest. Team third against Hay Springs. Heathershaw's free throw is up. No good. Tip attempt is no good. But Standing Bear gets the board, gets it back to Heathershaw. And so now the Warriors have a shot. Standing Bear takes a three from the corner. He misses. Ball's batted around. Collected by Moore. 4 seconds to go. And Twirling takes a three. He wasn't going to get it anyway. So that is the end of the first quarter. So 14-12 the score. We have a 1 minute break in the action, and we'll be right back from the Legion in just a few moments.
Hey, Doug, how'd that discount double check work out for you?
Oh, that was great. Good. I wish I had double checked before discussing that play earlier.
Did anybody catch that play?
No.
Okay, we're going to act like we're debating about it. You two do the bouncy football thing. You rub your head like it's a real tough call. No, that looks like you're having a migraine. I'm going to break the huddle confidently, and we're going to call it incomplete.
Your mic's on!
First down! Thank you!
70,000 people were there.
20 million more watching at home.
Got it!
Save big with State Farm.
And we are back at the Legion with this second quarter just beginning. Let's see, that is Alex Little White Man to inbound for the Warriors. Braden Loudon is seeing his first action of the night. Mo Curry now has it. Warriors are going big. Cotier takes another corner three. That one he gets to go. 17-12 now the score. Twirling has the ball for Hay Springs. He's got it at the top of the key. Gets a screen. Moves off to his right. Kicks it to the corner. Cade Moore. And it's good. Correction. That's Logan DaCosta. DaCosta hits the three to keep Hay Springs within two. Oh, it's hard screen by Loudon. And here goes Heathershaw. Throws it over to Cotier. Cotier takes another three. That rims around. No good. And it's rebounded by Moore. A push is going to be called, I believe, against Braden Loudon. That is going to go against Braden indeed. So that will be Braden's first foul of the contest. Team second against the Warriors. Twirling now has the ball. Crosses midcourt. gets a screen, goes to his right, kicks into, there's DaCosta, shoots it again. He doesn't even get the rim this time. Heathershaw with the easy board, brings it up the court. He's going to throw it, try to throw it inside. It's batted away. It's going to stay over here with the Warriors. Here goes little white man, throws into Heathershaw. Heathershaw to Cotier, now to Curry. Curry takes the three. It's off the rim, no good. Rebounded by Moore. Moore gets it over to DaCosta. DaCosta dribbles it up the court, gets it over to Varvel. Varvel throws it to Twarling. Oh boy, and we have a injury. Chucky Cotier must have had an issue with his glasses, and it must have hit him in the eye. He's having some trouble. So he's going to have to leave the game temporarily. Huber is back in the ball game for the Warriors. And here is Varvel. And Varvel throws it into Twarling. Twarling gets it over to DaCosta. DaCosta's having some trouble with the ball. Now he tries to dribble. He loses it. And it's taken away by Loudon, who gets it to Little White Man. Alex brings it up the court. He throws it over to Curry. Curry throws it in the corner to Huber. Huber throws inside to Curry. Curry puts it up, and that goes. 19-15, Warriors holding a four-point lead. Twarling has it up, bringing it up the court, crosses the midcourt line, throws it over to Toby Sherbarth. Oh, boy. And Cade Moore took the three and was fouled. So he is going to shoot three free throws right now. Foul will go against Frank Huber. Not a good foul there at all, but sometimes they happen. So Moore will shoot three. The first one is up. That's no good. And the second shot is up. That one doesn't go either. So here comes the third and final free throw of this event. And that shot is up. And it goes off too. So Moore goes 0-for-3. And the ball is going to be turned over to the Warriors. Curry has the ball for the Warriors, brings it up the court, crosses the midcourt line, drives off to his right, gets a screen, throws it inside to Heathershaw, wide open, and he gets it to go. Heathershaw gets it to go, 21-15 the score. Twarling now brings the ball up the court. He passes midcourt, he looks over to Toby, finds him. Oh, the ball's batted around, stolen by Frank Huber. Gets it to Heathershaw. Heathershaw now gets it to Curry, who walks up the court, throws it back to Heathershaw. Heathershaw looking for a screen. Throws it to Huber, and Huber throws it across court to Alex Little White Man, who drives. We have a whistle and a traveling call. We have two substitutions coming in. Standing Bear takes Loudon's place, and Alex Little White Man will come out. Sam Byrne will take his spot. Twarling has the ball for Hay Springs. He heads off to his right. Dribbles in, throws it back out to Varvel. Varvel takes a three, and he gets it to go. Varvel has a pretty sweet touch from three. He is either 3 of 4 or 3 of 5 right now. In any event, he's keeping Hay Springs in it. Standing Bear puts it up. It's no good. Rebounded by Moore. Tough rebound. Oh, and he bats it around. The ball is taken by Sam Byrne. Oh, boy, and they come away with a Heathershaw. Throws it across court to Curry. Curry throws it to Huber. Huber throws it over to Heathershaw. Heathershaw takes a three. And he gets it to go! The extra pass, a great extra pass by Huber to Heathershaw, who cashed it out from three. Oh boy, we're going to have a blocking foul against Curry. And that is the call. That is the first personal against Curry, the fourth team foul. Twarling takes the inbounds pass. He heads over to his right, takes a three, and he can't get it to go. It's rebounded by Standing Bear, throws it ahead to Sam Byrne, can't collect it clean, gets it back to Heathershaw. Heathershaw dribbles up, he'll take another three, and that's off the mark. Rebounded by DaCosta. DaCosta is hassled. Gives it to Varvel. Varvel to Twarling. Twarling's going to go aggressive, and he puts it up. It's no good, but a foul. And that is Curry, who's limping a little bit, but I think he'll be fine. So a blocking foul is called against Curry, his second of the contest, the fifth team foul. And they miss another free throw. Jade Byrne is checking into the game. Mo Curry will take a seat. Twarling will shoot the second. It's up, and he can't get that one to go, but Toby Sherbarth gets his rebound, but can't get that to go. So Toby Sherbarth was able to battle in, get the rebound, but couldn't get it to go. Now Heathershaw's got it at the top of the key. Throws it to Huber. Throws it back to Heathershaw. Huber collects a loose ball. Gets a Heathershaw in the corner. Heathershaw dribbles back to the top of the key. Gets it to Jade Byrne. Now goes over to Huber. Huber over to Byrne on inside. Whoa, the ball's thrown inside. Hits Jade in the back of the head. And it's turned over. Twarling now has the ball. Crosses half court. He gets a screen. Throws over Twarling. Now is going to take it all the way, but he's fouled. A hard foul committed by Sam Byrne. Twarling gets up a little gingerly. I don't know. He looks to be okay. He'll have to walk it off, but, boy, he hit the ground hard. Might have hit his tailbone. So that is Sam Byrne's first foul of the contest, the team sixth foul against the Warriors. So Twarling's at the line. The front end, he doesn't get. He's still favoring that tailbone that he just thumped on the ground a minute ago. So Twarling is at the line yet again. He puts up the shot. It's no good. Byrne with the rebound. And now Heathershaw's got it. Gets up the court to Jade. Back to Heathershaw. He's looking for a screen. Throws inside to Standing Bear. Back to Heathershaw. Now he takes a three. It's no good. Rebound by Huber. Long rebound. Heathershaw has the loose ball, throws it over to Byrne. Jade Byrne throws it to Standing Bear at the top of the key. Standing Bear dribbles, throws it to Huber. Huber now to Jade. Now inside to Heathershaw. Whoa! And they're going to call Twarling. Twarling ran inside to try and collect that ball. There was a hard collision, and they'll call him for the foul. That is his first of the contest, the fourth team foul against Hay Springs. Heathershaw takes a long pass, throws it over to Jade Byrne. Jade dribbles, gives it back to Huber, throws it over to Sam. Sam back to Jade. Jade dribbles to his right, gives it to Heathershaw. Heathershaw into the corner to Byrne. Now inside to Standing Bear. They try to feed Heathershaw inside, and they get him in good. Heathershaw knifed inside. They found him with the pass, and he puts it up off the glass and good. 26-18 the score. And now Standing Bear picks off the pass. He's heading up. He tries to throw it across court. The ball will go out of bounds off of Hay Springs. Curry's back in the game. Huber will take a seat. 2 minutes and 57 seconds to go. 26-18 the score. Sam Byrne to inbound. Throws it into Heathershaw in the corner. Heathershaw throws outside to Jade. Now outside to Curry. Curry feeds inside to Standing Bear. Standing Bear back up top to Heathershaw. Now Curry. And Curry takes the three. And he gets it to go. 29-18 now the score. Varvel brings it up the court. Jade Byrne goes for the steal, doesn't quite get it. Oh, and he traveled. So Jade Byrne hassled him, and then he traveled. Heathershaw has the ball, gives it back to Curry. Warriors have an 11-point lead. Sam Byrne dribbles. Whoa, ball is batted around, and Twarling takes it away from him. And Sam Byrne is able to get it back, though. And Jade ends up collecting it. Gets it ahead to Curry. Curry fakes to Standing Bear. And a good move. Fakes the pass and puts it up for two. It's good. A 13-point lead now opened up by the Warriors. 31-18. And now here's Twarling. Gets it over to Moore. Moore throws across to Varvel. And Varvel and Moore having an exchange. He threw it across the court. Varvel couldn't handle it. It went out of bounds, and Varvel was clearly upset coming away from it. Curry throws over to Heathershaw. Header shot back to Curry. Curry, fake shot, gives it out to Sage Fly, who has just checked in. Fly dribbles around, gives it back to Jade. Now back to Heathershaw, drives the baseline, uncontested and good. So 33-18 now the score. Twarling brings it up the court. And there is DaCosta, gets it back to Varvel. Varvel takes the three, and he doesn't quite get it. It's close, though, rebounded by DaCosta. DaCosta gets it back to Varvel. Varvel takes another three. That one doesn't go. Rebounded by Loudon. And now Curry's got it. Warriors are pushing. Throws it ahead to Sage Fly. Fly can't get it. And it's rebounded by Varvel. Twarling now pushing up the court. Feeds inside to Moore. Moore puts it up and gets it to go. So some great hustle there by the big man as he gets down the court and puts in the layup. And Curry now has the ball. Throws it over to Heathershaw. Heathershaw drives the baseline yet again. And there's just the Hay Springs Hawks simply have no one who is capable of matching Heathershaw athletically, or with the maybe athletically, but not with the length combined. So really tough matchup for Hay Springs tonight. Curry now has the ball, 30 seconds to go in the first half. He dribbles to the right, feeds Jade Byrne. Byrne throws up top to Heathershaw. Now to Sage Fly. Fly dribbles over to the right, feeds Curry. Curry will take the three, and it's off the mark. No good. Rebounded by Loudon, and Loudon is able to put it up and good. Tough rebound by Loudon, and he gets the putback. 37-20 now the score. There's Twarling. Twarling dribbles to his right, and it's almost stolen. DaCosta has it, throws it to Toby Sherbarth, and he gets the bank. It is now 6 o'clock, but Toby Sherbarth was able to find the bank open. So 37-22 is the score going into the half. We will have a 10-minute halftime, and then we'll be right back with Warrior Radio.
Hey, Doug, how'd that discount double check work out for you?
Oh, that was great. Good. I wish I had double checked before discussing that play earlier.
Did anybody catch that play?
No.
Okay, we're going to act like we're debating about it. You two do the bouncy football thing. You rub your head like it's a real tough call. No, that looks like you're having a migraine. I'm going to break the huddle confidently, and we're going to call it incomplete.
Your mic's on! First down! Thank you!
70,000 people were there.
20 million more watching at home.
Got it!
Save big with State Farm.
Whether you're traveling to or from the game, make a stop at Discount Fuel in Kadoka. They have a large variety of foods from hot stuffed pizza, roasted chicken, sub sandwiches, and their famous chicken gizzards. They can accommodate large groups and orders. Call them at 605-837-2271. While filling your belly, refuel your tanks with gas or diesel. They look forward to serving your needs. Discount Fuel and Kadoka Oil are proud supporters of area student athletes and wish them the best of luck in all their activities. Bennett County Hospital, Nursing Home, and Rural Health Clinic is your local health care provider. They offer a full-time ambulance service, physical therapy, home health care, occupational therapy, and outpatient psychiatry. Bennett County Healthcare Services will provide your family with lifelong health care from infancy to the later years with top-notch nursing home care. They remind you to get your yearly checkup and don't forget those flu shots. Bennett County Healthcare Providers are proud sponsors of all Bennett County students and wish them the best in all their school activities.
Life's an adventure.
Taking electricity for granted is something I hope I never do. I use it every day, for school, charging my cell phone, and getting ready in the morning. It's an important part of my life, and without La Creek Electric Cooperative, these things would not be possible. I even use the power poles to guide me in my running routine. Now that's using power to the maximum. Thanks, La Creek Electric, you make my day even better.
Well, it finally happened, Zachary. Somebody burned down my she shed.
Nobody burned down your she shed, Cheryl.
Well, my she shed's on fire.
Your she shed was struck by lightning.
Zachary, is my she shed covered by State Farm?
Your she shed's covered, Cheryl.
You hear that, Victor? I'm getting a new she shear she shed.
She shear?
Mm-hmm.
That's wonderful news.
Go with the one that's here to help life go right. State Farm.
Ooh.
It seems around here every town is a sports town. And why not? Sports were important to us growing up, and we want the same for our kids. To get involved, to compete, because that's how kids learn to lead. And why Farmers Union Insurance supports these programs. They know sports aren't just about building skill and strength, but about building character. Farmers Union Insurance. They don't just protect our community, they invest in it.
Taking electricity for granted is something I hope I never do. I use it every day, for school, charging my cell phone, and getting ready in the morning. It's an important part of my life, and without La Creek Electric Cooperative, these things would not be possible. I even use the power poles to guide me in my running routine. Now that's using power to the maximum. Thanks, La Creek Electric, you make my day even better.
Well, it finally happened, Zachary. Somebody burned down my she shed.
Nobody burned down your she shed, Cheryl.
Well, my she shed's on fire.
Your she shed was struck by lightning.
Zachary, is my she shed covered by State Farm?
Your she shed's covered, Cheryl.
You hear that, Victor? I'm getting a new she shear she shed.
She shear?
Mm-hmm.
That's wonderful news.
Go with the one that's here to help life go right. State Farm.
Hey, Doug, how'd that discount double check work out for you?
Oh, that was great. Great. I wish I had double checked before discussing that play earlier.
Did anybody catch that play?
No.
Okay, we're going to act like we're debating about it. You two do the bouncy football thing. You rub your head like it's a real tough call. No, that looks like you're having a migraine. I'm going to break the huddle confidently, and we're going to call it incomplete.
Your mic's on! First down! Thank you!
70,000 people were there.
20 million more watching at home.
Got it!
Save big with State Farm.
Whether you're traveling to or from the game, make a stop at Discount Fuel in Kadoka. They have a large variety of foods from hot stuff pizza, roasted chicken, sub sandwiches, and their famous chicken gizzards. They can accommodate large groups and orders. Call them at 605-837-2271. While filling your belly, refuel your tanks with gas or diesel. They look forward to serving your needs. Discount Fuel and Kadoka Oil are proud supporters of area student athletes and wish them the best of luck in all their activities. Bennett County Hospital, Nursing Home, and Rural Health Clinic is your local health care provider. They offer a full-time ambulance service, physical therapy, home health care, occupational therapy, and outpatient psychiatry. Bennett County Health Care Services will provide your family with lifelong health care from infancy to the later years with top-notch nursing home care. They remind you to get your yearly checkup and don't forget those flu shots. Bennett County Health Care Providers are proud sponsors of all Bennett County students and wish them the best in all their school activities.
Life's an adventure filled with excitement, challenges, and achievement. Farmers Union Insurance can provide you the safety net to keep you moving toward your goals and enjoying life's rewards. With multiple locations across the state, Farmers Union Insurance agents provide quick quotes and professional services you deserve. Since 1948, Farmers Union Insurance has focused on insuring the people of South Dakota. From the most remote quarter section to the busiest intersection, Farmers Union Insurance, insuring a brighter tomorrow.
Living in a remote rural area can be a challenge, but the electric cooperatives have not only kept up, but have moved forward with the advancement of technology. Having three young daughters, we can enjoy living in the country and still have all the comforts just like any other community. It really is quite remarkable. Dependable, reliable service. That's La Creek Electric Cooperative.
A message from La Creek Electric, your local Touchstone Cooperative.
This is Barbara. Barbara likes doing adventurous things, like bungee jumping.
Ow!
Barbara likes to take chances, but not with her finances, which is why she banks at Security First Bank. Their straightforward checking, savings, and lending services mean she never has to take a leap of faith.
Woo-hoo!
Security First Bank. A relationship you can count on. Member FDIC.
We hope you are all enjoying the student productions of your school. Tonight's event and every event produced by your school during the school year are created, filmed, and produced by the students you love to follow and support. Become a booster of your school's live event coverage by becoming a sponsor. It's a great way to show your support of the athletes and students in your community. As a sponsor, you'll get great visibility for your business, organization, or family by supporting the live productions of your school.
Hey, Doug, how'd that discount double check work out for you?
Oh, that was great. I wish I had double checked before discussing that play earlier.
Did anybody catch that play?
No.
Okay, we're going to act like we're debating about it. You two do the bouncy football thing. You rub your head like it's a real tough call. No, that looks like you're having a migraine. I'm going to break the huddle confidently, and we're going to call it incomplete.
Your mic's on! First down! Thank you!
70,000 people were there.
20 million more watching at home.
Got it!
Save big with State Farm.
Whether you're traveling to or from the game, make a stop at Discount Fuel in Kidoka. They have a large variety of foods from hot stuffed pizza, roasted chicken, sub sandwiches, and their famous chicken gizzards. They can accommodate large groups and orders. Call them at 605-837-2271. While filling your belly, refuel your tanks with gas or diesel. They look forward to serving your needs. Discount Fuel and Kidoka Oil are proud supporters of area student athletes and wish them the best of luck in all their activities.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Legion for this third quarter, which we're about to get underway. The Hawks will start with the ball. That is Varvel to inbound. Number two throws into number one, Twirling. Twirling now brings it up the court. He throws it over here to DeCoste. DeCoste now throws back to Twirling. Twirling dribbles down from the elbow. He moves back to the top of the key. He dribbles off to his right. Gets a screen. Throws it to the corner to DeCoste. DeCoste dribbles around. Now gets it back to Twirling in the corner. Twirling is trapped, and the ball is taken away by Curry. Curry gets ahead to Heathershaw. Heathershaw takes it up, and it's good. As usual tonight, Heathershaw has basically had his way. So with no one to challenge him, Twirling brings it up the court, dribbles to his left. Oh, boy, they're going to call him for a carry. So 39-22, 7 minutes and 12 seconds to go. Warriors have a 17-point lead. Here goes Alex Little White Man, throws it to Curry. Curry brings it up the court, throws it over to Heathershaw, into the corner to Huber, who takes the shot. He doesn't get it to go. Ball goes through Varvel's legs, and Cotier has come back in the game. Curry takes a long three. That doesn't go. Battled for, and Moore gets the rebound. Ball swatted around, and Twirling will come up with it. Throws it ahead to Varvel. Varvel back to Twirling. Twirling will take the three, and he gets it to go. 39-25 the score. Curry brings the ball up the court. Crosses half court. Heads over to his right. Curry has the ball. Throws it inside to Alex, Little White Man. Gets it to Heathershaw. Heathershaw with the feed. It's good. Heathershaw with a scoop on the drive gets the layup to go. And there's Twirling. Oh, boy, he moved that step, and he knew it. And we knew it, too. We'll get him a luggage at some point he can take with him. And Heathershaw to inbound, throws it into Curry. Curry throws back to Heathershaw. Heathershaw throws inside to Little White Man, throes back to Cotier. Cotier loses it out of bounds. 41-25 the score now. Twirling will inbound. Throws it away. And there is... that is DeCoste who will throw it in. He throws it in to Twirling. Twirling goes across. He puts it up. Oh, man, a sweet move, but he couldn't get it to go. And that one's going to go out of bounds in favor of the Warriors. And there is Alex Little White Man. Throws it to Cotier. Back to Curry. Throws it to Cotier. Now in the corner to Huber. Back to Cotier. Throws inside to Heathershaw. Heathershaw feeds Alex Little White Man. Puts it up and good. A nice feed by Heathershaw. And Alex Little White Man finishes it to put the Warriors up by 18. And here goes Varvel. Varvel dribbles to his right, now back to his left, top of the key, throws the ball over to Twarling. Twarling dribbles around, guarded by Curry. Tries to go inside. Ball is taken away by Frank Huber. Frank on the runaway. And he has to pick it up. Gives back to Alex Little White Man. Heathershaw will take the three. It's, oh boy, an air ball. But Frank Huber's got it. Curry now takes the, oh, correction, that's Cotier. Hits the long two, now putting the Warriors up by 20. Now Twarling brings it up the court. He's heading over to his right. Throws it inside to Toby. Toby gives to Varvel. Varvel dribbles around. He gives it back to DeCoste. And we got a traveling call. And too bad for Hay Springs, because DeCoste did hit the three. So, Hubert inbound to Curry. Curry now walking it up the court. Throws it into the corner to Heathershaw. Inside to Alex the White Man on the give and go. Gives it to Heathershaw, and he gets it off the glass and good. Heathershaw scores again to make it 47-25. Twarling, oh boy, we're gonna have a timeout. A full timeout taken by the Hawks. So, we have a 60-second break, and we will be right back after these messages.
Hey, Doug, how'd that discount double check work out for you?
Oh, that was great. Good. I wish I had double checked before discussing that play earlier.
Did anybody catch that play?
No.
Okay, we're going to act like we're debating about it. You two do the bouncy football thing. You rub your head like it's a real tough call. No, that looks like you're having a migraine. I'm going to break the huddle confidently, and we're going to call it incomplete.
Your mic's on! First down! Thank you!
70,000 people were there.
20 million more watching at home.
Got it!
Save big with State Farm.
Whether you're traveling to or from the game, make a stop at Discount Fuel in Kidoka. They have a large variety of foods, from hot stuff pizza, roasted chicken, sub sandwiches, and their famous chicken gizzards. They can accommodate large groups and orders. Call them at 605-837-2271. While filling your belly, refuel your tank.
He gets the inbound pass, and that doesn't go. Rebounded by Heathershaw. Curry brings up the court, throws up to Cotier. Cotier splits the double team, puts up the runner, and he gets it to go! 49-25, now the score. Twarling brings it up the court. Feeds inside to Toby. Oh boy, his ball is stripped away by Curry. Now Cotier's got it on the runaway, and he gets it off the glass. Rebounded by Alex the White Man. Oh, but he's fouled. So Alex the White Man tried to go back up. He got blocked, but there was too much contact, and so that's number 13. That is DeCoste, who will pick up the foul. That is the first team foul against the Hawks. A mass substitution here coming. Three Warriors will check into the game after this first free throw. The first one's up and no good. Huber, Curry, and presumably Alex, if he makes this, will leave the game. Sam Byrne and Lyle Cotier have checked in for the Warriors. That second shot is up. It's no good. Rebounded by Toby. And here goes Twarling. Dribbles it up the court. Dribbles up. That is DeCoste. DeCoste feeds Toby inside. Back to DeCoste. DeCoste takes the three. And he gets it to go. With a sweet touch outside. So here's Heathershaw. Throws it into the corner to Byrne. Back to the top to Cotier. Cotier feeds inside to Alex Little White Man. The ball's battled for. We're going to have a jump ball. And it's going to stay with the Warriors. And now Tate Standing Bear will finally check into the game. Alex Little White Man comes out. Here comes the inbounds from the baseline by Sam. Gets it to Lyle. Lyle throws it into Standing Bear. Back to Cotier, who takes the three. Can't get it to go. Rebounded by Sam Byrne. A strong rebound. Batted around, and Twarling comes away with it. Twarling will dribble inside. Splits the double team. Loses it. And the ball will stay on this end. 49-28 now the score. DeCoste to inbound. Throws over to Varvel. Varvel takes the three. Doesn't get it. And Cade Moore gets the putback, but he can't get it to go. Sam Byrne now has the rebound. Chucky Cotier collects the ball, throws it up court to the corner. Heathershaw goes inside to Standing Bear. Back to Chucky. Chucky with a fadeaway. Can't get it to go. Rebounded by DeCoste. DeCoste looks for someone to throw to. Throws over to Varvel. Varvel gets to Twarling. Twarling feeds DeCoste, who will take another three, and that one's way off the mark. Standing Bear gets the rebound. Chucky Cotier throws up to Heather Shaw. Heather Shaw goes for it. We have a foul call. And that is DeCoste with his second foul of the contest, the second team foul. And James Sherbarth comes into the game. He will take the place of Cade Moore. So Moore, a stockier build, will leave the game. Sam Burned inbound. Throws into Chucky. Chucky puts up off the glass. No good. Rebound by Toby. Gets over to Varvel. Varvel dribbles off to his left. Gets it to Twarling. Twarling dribbles in the middle of the court. Throws it to Varvel. Varvel looks for someone to pass to. Gets a screen. Oh, a moving screen. Yep, a moving screen by Toby Sherbarth is going to result in a turnover. His third of the contest, third team foul against Hay Springs. Chucky Cotier throws it into Lyle. Lyle walks up the court, gets it back to Chucky. Chucky stops, throws it to Standing Bear. Standing Bear goes inside to Nick Dubre, and Dubre throws it out of bounds. Lyle had knifed inside, and Nick Dubre was just behind with the pass. So that will be a turnover. And now Twarling has the ball, coming back up the court. Throws it over to DeCoste. DeCoste is wide open, takes a three, and he gets it to go. DeCoste has shown he has a sweet touch from outside. He gets that one. 49-31. Chucky takes a shot. No good. Rebound. Battled for. And that is DeCoste going to come away with it. Oh, boy, a foul. Ooh, Nick Dubre is called for the push. So that'll be his first of the contest. First team foul. And now Curry and Loudon are going to be subbing in soon. Here goes Twarling. Twarling picks up the dribble. Tries to go across, but Sam Burns steals it. He throws the head to Chucky. Throws inside to Lyle, and Lyle puts it up and good. A beautiful piece of fast break right there by the Warriors. And now Twarling has the ball coming back up the court. He throws inside to DeCoste. Now Twarling's got to shoot a corner three. Way off the mark. Doesn't even get the rim. Lyle now has it moving up the court. He's going all the way, it looks like. And he does! He gets it to go. What a move by Lyle! Lyle gets it to go. You just knew that he was going to go with that one when we saw him going up the court. Twarling goes back. Sam Byrne with the steal. Throws over to Chucky. Chucky dribbles it up the court. He feeds Lyle in the corner. Lyle gets it back to Chucky. Chucky, oh boy, the ball kind of gets away from him. The ball ends up out of bounds. And it's going to go over to the Hawks. So, we have a couple of subs. Chucky's coming out of the game. Standing Bear also will be coming out of the game. Twarling takes the inbounds pass. Dribbles up the court. Passes half court. Throws it over to DeCoste. DeCoste back to Varvel. Varvel looking, is dribbling around. Guarded by Lyle. He gets a screen. Throws it in the corner to DeCoste. DeCoste, oh, and Sam just takes the ball away from him. Oh, no, now DeCoste is down injured, it appears. He gets back up. Oh, boy, he's trying to tough it out. He's still limping around. It looks like Cade Moore is going to have to come back in the game. It could be that he just needs to tie his shoe. He grabbed his knee when he first went down, and it looked like he could be seriously injured. He's still hobbling around. We hope he's okay. But for the moment, Cade Moore will be back in the game. Here's Varvel to inbound. Throws it inside to Toby. Toby, oh boy, and Toby gets it poked out by Sam, but he's able to get it back. He's still looking. Dribbles. Oh, he splits the double team. We have a foul. And the foul is going to be called against Curry. That is the second team foul against the Warriors, the third personal against Curry. So Twarling will take the inbound pass. walks it up the court. Oh boy, now he sees an opening. He takes it with the ball swatted around. Toby goes away, comes away with it. Shot by his brother James. Oh, just kind of shot from the hip, and it goes way off the mark. Sam just launches it into nowhere, and it's taken away by Twarling. Twarling now dribbles up the court. He puts it up, a wild shot. No good. Rebound, battled for, and there's going to be a fight for it. Lyle gets the jump ball, and it's going to stay with the Hawks. But Lyle got on the floor and went for it. So here's Varvel, throws it into Twarling. Twarling dribbling around. He gets a screen, now moves back. Oh boy, faked out Curry bad, and he takes a three. It's off the mark, no good. Rebounded by Loudon. Loudon, oh, and then Lyle with the presence of mind to launch that ball, knowing there wasn't much time left. So, third quarter's over. We have a 1 minute break before we'll be back with the final quarter of play here from the Legion.
Hey, Doug, how'd that discount double check work out for you?
Oh, that was great. Good. I wish I had double checked before discussing that play earlier.
Did anybody catch that play?
No.
Okay, we're going to act like we're debating about it. You two do the bouncy football thing. You rub your head like it's a real tough call. No, that looks like you're having a migraine. I'm going to break the huddle confidently, and we're going to call it incomplete.
Mic's on! First down! Thank you!
70,000 people were there.
20 million more watching at home.
Got it!
Save big with State Farm.
Whether you're traveling to or from the game, make a stop at Discount Fuel in Kadoka. They have a large variety of foods from hot stuffed pizza, roasted chicken, sub sandwiches, and their famous chicken gizzards. They can accommodate large groups and orders. Call them at 605-837-2271. While filling your belly, refuel your tanks with gas or diesel. They look forward to serving your needs. Discount Fuel and Kadoka Oil are proud supporters of area student athletes and wish them the best of luck in all their activities.
All right, and we're back with the fourth quarter of action about to resume play here at the Legion in Martin, South Dakota. Curry takes the ball, throws it over to Sage. Sage works to the middle, gets to the top of the key, throws it back to Heathershaw. Heathershaw throws inside to Lyle. Lyle goes back outside to Curry. Curry's going to take the three. It rims around, and Cade Moore comes up with the board. And now we have DeCoste, who's dribbling up the court, using the elbow, him and Lyle battling it out. And there's Twarling. Dribbling around, guarded by Heathershaw, moves to his left, goes back to DeCoste. DeCoste looks for a pass. He's guarded heavy by Lyle. He drives, puts it up, and it's too strong. Sage Fly with the board. Sage throws it to Curry. Curry's wide open, gives it to Heathershaw. Heathershaw drives, finds Sage inside, and he gets it to go. 55-31 the score. Twarling throws it into Toby. Toby back outside to Varvel. Puts it up. It's no good. Off the rim. DeCoste gets the board. Twarling takes the three now. That's off the mark. Rebounded by... It's knocked out of bounds by Heathershaw, but he looked shoved to me. But there's no foul call. And we're going to have a sub. Curry's coming out. Lyle's coming out. In the game come Chucky Cotier and Frank Huber. Frank the Tank, as we like to call him. Better watch out when Frank walks down the hallway. All right. Twarling has the ball, throws up top to Varvel, has it at the top of the key, guarded by Jade Byrne. Dribbles around, tries to move to his right, but Jade stays in his way. Gets it back to Twarling, guarded by Cotier. Throws it to DeCoste, now has it, guarded by Frank Huber. He drives, he puts it up, we have a whistle and a foul on the floor. And it looks like we're going to have a timeout called by the Hawks. So the 30-second timeout taken by Coach Olson, and we will be right back in 30 seconds.
This is Barbara. Barbara likes doing adventurous things, like bungee jumping.
Ow!
Barbara likes to take chances, but not with her finances, which is why she banks at Security First Bank. Their straightforward checking, savings, and lending services means she never has to take a leap of faith.
Woo-hoo!
Security First Bank, a relationship you can count on. Member FDIC.
And welcome back to our broadcast. I am Michael Barneau. My second in command is Hunter Connect. We're here with 6 minutes and 41 seconds to go. Twarling to inbound for the Hawks. He's having trouble with the inbound pass. Gets it to Varvel. Varvel will take the three. It's off the mark and no good. Rebounded by Fly. 55-31 the score. Heather Shaw brings it up the court. Then he stops at the three. He gives over to Sage Fly. Fly looks to drive. Now moves over to the middle. Huber has it. Top of the key. Throws over to Cotier. Cotier is going to take the three. That's off the mark. Rebounded by DeCoste. The double team comes and Sage flies all over him and he throws to Varvel. Varvel throws up to Toby. Toby finds a wide open Twarling who misses the three. The ball goes out of bounds. Looks like it's going to stay on this end. So here we are. DeCoste now has the ball on the out of bounds. He's trying to find somebody. Oh boy, he throws it all the way across court. Twarling collects it on his side of the mid-court line. Tries to go inside. Oh, he traveled. He wanted the pass, but Huber denied it, and he moved his pivot foot. So, Huber now to inbound for the Warriors. Throws it into Cotier, who dribbles across half-court, gets it to Fly. Fly dribbles to the top of the key, gets it over to Jade Byrne. Jade now dribbles in the middle. He gets to Heathershaw. Heathershaw drives, feeds inside. We have a foul, a blocking foul. Foul on the floor. 5 minutes and 50 seconds to go. Number one, that is Twarling, his second foul of the contest. We have a sub coming. Alex Little White Man will take the place of Jacoby Heathershaw. Chucky Cotier to inbound. Throws it way up top to Alex. Alex steps, gives it to Huber. Now to Fly. Fly will take the three. It's off the front of the iron. No good. Battled for it, and Chucky loses his glasses again. Ugh. Just can't keep them on tonight. But, so looks like we have a continuation in play. We'll go back out of bounds. So here goes Alex. Here goes Alex to inbound. Throws inside to Jade. Jade throws up to Fly. Fly collects it. Throws it to Chucky. Chucky throws inside to Alex, and there's a foul again on the floor. That will go. Foul will go number 21. That's Cade Moore. The fifth team foul against the Hawks. Now Byrne is. Jade Byrne comes out. Sam Byrne comes in. Throws up top to Fly. Fly throws over to Chucky. Chucky dribbles into the middle, throws it over to Alex. Alex steps, takes the three, off the mark, no good. Rebound by Sam, thrown out of bounds, and it will stay with the Warriors. Here comes James Sherbarth is coming into the game for Cade Moore. All right, so here we go. Chucky takes the long pass, puts up the three, and it's good. Nothing but net. Chucky Cotier gets it to go. 58-31 now the score. Twarling dribbles up the court. He moves off to his right. He takes a jumper. No good. Rebound by Sam Byrne. Throws it up to Chucky. Chucky is getting aggressive now. We'll take it, and it's no good. Rebounded by Twarling. Oh, and a foul on the floor. A push. They're going to call Sam Byrne for the foul. All right, so that is the fourth team foul, the second personal against Sam Byrne. Lyle Cotier and Chucky checking into the game. Frank and Sage will sit. 5 minutes to go, 58-31 the score. DeCoste takes the inbounds pass. He dribbles up the court, tries to get a screen. Kicks out to Twarling in the corner. Twarling comes in the middle. Gives back to, he launches it from the hip. It's way off the mark, but Toby gets a rebound, and it's good. So James got the pass and just shot it from the hip from three, and there's Lyle taking a three. It rims around, can't get it to go, but Alex saves it. Now Mo will take the three. That doesn't go. Rebound collected by DeCoste, and the foul is going to be called against the Warriors.
So Varvel.
Oh, boy. Toby jumped for the ball. Couldn't quite get it to go. So here goes Chucky. Comes up the court. Throws out to Mo. Mo fakes a three. Thinks about it. Whoa, he throws it to Sam, who almost ran by him. Lyle has it. Throws it up to Chucky. No, no, that's Chucky taking the shot now. He gets the bank. 60-43. That 27-point lead now for the Warriors. Varvel brings up the court. Throws it to Toby. Toby throws it. He looks to drive. Throws out to Varvel. Varvel take the three. It's way off the mark. Curry's got the board. And the Warriors are pushing. Throws into Sam. Sam Byrne finds Alex Little White Man. Little White Man puts it up. It's no good. Battle for... Oh, boy. And it's going to go over to Hay Springs. So Loudon and Standing Bear coming into the game. Alex Little White Man and Sam Byrne will sit. And now here we go. DeCoste throws it to Twarling. Twarling brings up the court. Throws it over to James Sherbath, who did think about it, and boy, he launches another one. Oh my goodness. And it's taken by Chucky Cotier. Gives it to Mo. Mo with the long rebound. Oh, it's taken by Toby. And Lyle doesn't come away with the steal. And now Varvel's dribbling up the court. He throws it up. Whoa, just avoid the over and back. And he launches another one. There's James again. And he puts up another shot. And he gets it to go. He gets the board, and he gets it to go, shooting from the hip. Here goes Chucky. All right, and here he goes. Chucky on the drive, puts it up. It's good. 62-35. Varvel now has the ball for the Hawks, coming up the court. They throw the long pass to Toby. He collects it. A very dramatic catch. And Varvel will take a long three. Whoa, he doesn't get anything. Oh, boy, Standing Bear bats it away. DeCoste now has the ball, throws it to James, and he gets it to go again! And there is James Sherbarth. Hits two shots in a row. Throws out to Lyle. Lyle will take the three. It's off the rim, no good. Rebounded by Toby. There's DeCoste. Throws it back to Toby, and he throws out of bounds. Toby wasn't expecting the pass. And it went out of bounds. So Nick Dubray coming into the game. He will take Tate Standing Bear's spot. And now here is Varvel to inbound. Throws it into Twarling. Twarling. Oh, boy. Ball is stolen by Curry. Curry's got the runaway. Puts it up. And it's good. And he gets the and one. He will have the opportunity for the and one. The basket counts. That is the fourth foul on Toby Sherbarth. Now Cade Moore is coming into the game. Twarling is taking a seat. Curry from the line. And he gets it to go. All right, so there's Varvel taking the pass. DeCoste throws into Moore. Moore throws it up. It's no good. Loudon has the board. Throws it over to Jade Byrne. Jade brings up the court. Throws it to Dubray. Dubray takes a three. Doesn't get it to go. Rebounded by Toby. Toby gives to Varvel. Varvel throws it ahead to DeCoste. DeCoste goes between the legs. Doesn't get it to go. Trying to go inside. Now that goes out to Toby. Now Varvel's got it for three. And that's off the mark. Dubray throws it over to Lyle. Lyle brings up the court. He throws out to Frank Huber. Frank gives it out to Dubray. Dubray throws up the three. Can't get it to go. To Jade Byrne. Now Lyle takes a long three. He can't get that to go. battled for, and DeCoste comes away with it. He's coming up the court now. He's going to stop, pop, take the three. No good. Cade Moore with the board, and now Loudon's got it, and there goes Cade Moore with a bear hug. Unfortunately, this isn't football. And Loudon gets fouled. That is the sixth. Nope, that is the seventh team foul, so now Loudon's going to the line for the front end of the 1-1. Here we go. So here goes Braden Loudon with an opportunity from the line. Shot is up, and it's no good. Off the mark. Rebounded by Nick Dubre. Dubre puts it up. It's no good. Rebounded by Lyle. And Lyle puts up the shot. And that doesn't go. Jade gives it out here. Frank Huber takes the three. Oh, I can't get it. Now Toby's got it on the runway. Toby stops that past half court. Oh, ball stolen by Lyle. Lyle's heading up the court. Stops. He almost loses it. And he throws it to Jade Byrne. And now DeCoste steals it from him. DeCoste is heading up the court. He stops at three-point line. Throws inside to Cade Moore. Moore gives it back to DeCoste. DeCoste takes the three. It's too far. He didn't even get the rim. Dubre throws it toward the Jade. And now Jade's going to go for the layup. He gets it to go. And that puts the Warriors up by an even 30. With 10 seconds to go, here goes Varvel. Varvel throws it out to... Oh, boy. Toby takes the last shot. It's no good. Ball's rimmed around. Rebounded by Brown, by Braden Loudon. And that is how this one's going to end. 67-37 the score. The Warriors take this one on the strength of a great night from Heather Shaw, Cotier, and others. So, this is Michael Barno, and my second in command is Hunter Connect, as well as some help from Zach Fisher tonight. We are signing off. We appreciate you listening in.
Good work, Hunter.